Hello and welcome to Indian Kitchen Flavors. Today I'll be showing you how to prepare this delicious, spicy and tangy paneer curry. So let's get started. Here on a medium flame, I have a pan heating up. We will add in some oil. We'll add around 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil in it. And we will let the oil heat up. Once the oil is hot, I'm going to add some bay leaf and some cinnamon stick. After bay leaf, cinnamon changes color, we are going to add in garlic. Here I have around 10 garlics which I have chopped into fine pieces. Cook garlic for few seconds. Next we are going to add onions. I have here 3 finely sliced onions. We are going to add it in here. And we will cook the onions till they are soft. Now once the onions are slightly cooked, I am going to add 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. And we are going to cook this until the raw smell of ginger garlic goes. Now our onions, ginger garlic paste is all cooked properly. Next, here I have 1 small capsicum or green pepper that have been sliced into fine slices. We are going to add it now. And we will cook this until the capsicums are slightly soft but still crunchy. So the capsicums are done now. Next we are going to add in bhuna masala. This is onion and tomato paste that I have prepared. I have a recipe of how to make bhuna masala on my channel. I will be posting the link at the end of the video. You can have a look. So I am going to add around 4 tablespoons of bhuna masala now. If you don't have bhuna masala, you can add the puree of 2 tomatoes. Now we'll mix everything nicely. Now I'm going to add some spices in it. So first I have around 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, around 2 teaspoons of coriander powder, 1/4 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of degi mirch or Kashmiri red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of kitchen king masala. If you don't have kitchen king masala, you can add garam masala as well. Next we are going to add around 2 tablespoons of fenugreek seeds or kasuri methi. Mix everything well. Now to this I am going to add around 2 teaspoons of curd. Make sure the flame is on low, otherwise the curd will curdle. And we will mix it nicely. Now as you can see, our masala is all ready. It has started to ooze out oil. Now here I have around 250 grams of paneer or cottage cheese which I have chopped into small thick slices, so adding in to the masala. Mix it. Next, I'm going to add some water, around 1/2 cup. Now add salt to taste. Mix. To this, I'm going to add a small cube of butter. This is optional. If you want to add, you can. Otherwise, you can skip adding butter. To finish off, I'm adding some coriander leaves. These are clean, fresh, chopped coriander leaves. Now we'll switch off the flame and we'll take this out in a serving platter. Here our paneer curry is all ready to be served. So do give it a try and share your feedbacks with me in the comment section below. If you like today's recipe, please don't forget to like, subscribe and share this video with your friends. Do follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Indian Kitchen Flavors. Thank you for watching. I'll see you again with a new video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.